All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. All right. Thank you guys very much for joining me. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Hey, man, we try to break this thing down every way from Sunday. We try to go college football, NFL, NBA, everything. In this video, I'm talking about college football. I try to break down the whole thing. I go through about top 15, maybe around there. I go games last week, games the next week. And then I talk about any of the bowls happening up here pretty soon, people. I love college football. I think you guys do too. So let's talk about some college football, man. Chat if you got some comments, people. Let's get it on. Number one, I got Bama. Bama, man, you know Bama's bomb this year. And the defense isn't going to let up at all. I think Bama goes all the way. They're undefeated this year. You get another championship. Congratulations, Bama. I think everybody else should just start looking at bowls, because bowls are going to be where everything's going to be, where all the action is. Don't give up on the bowls just because you got the 4-team playoff. I think the bowls are going to provide a lot of really good entertainment this year. So, Michigan, number two. Oh, forgot. Bama goes against LSU next week. You can't forget that. They just come off a bye. Now they get LSU. That's a huge game. Obviously, they're going to win. But it's a good game for LSU. Michigan. Michigan beats Michigan State. Had to have this game for Michigan. They're the number two team in the country. They're going to play Maryland. They're going to crush Maryland. I don't think Michigan loses another game, and I think they beat Ohio State. Ohio State looks shaky right now. I think we all can see that, right? So Michigan looks good. The defense looks good. It looks dynamic, and you got Harbaugh as a maniac, and I think this, they're just in the window right now. Whether or not they win the whole dang thing, they're not, because they're going to lose to somebody. But it would be great to see Michigan and Washington playing that 14 playoff. That's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping they're number two and three. That's my dream, okay? Now, let's do number three, Washington. Washington is a cream of the crop team. They're the best team in the Pac-12. Pac-12 is one of the best conferences in the country. They're top four. I'm not saying they're number one. They're top four. Give it to Michigan. Give it to Washington. Let them do Rose Bowl. I think it's going to be great. It should set up for it right now. Get fired up for it right now. It was probably the Rose Bowl in 1989, 1990, 1990, 1986, 1987, whatever it was. Any of those years. Michigan was great in the 80s. Washington was great in the 80s. Let's do Rose Bowl again. Then we go fourth with Clemson. Let Clemson, if they win it out and if they go there, which they did, they barely beat Florida State, game of the week, obviously. But let them go play Bama. Let them be the Sugar Bowl. Let Bama do its thing. Let it go Southern style, okay? Clemson plays Syracuse. They're going to win. Ohio State beats Northwestern, but barely. Ohio State beats Northwestern, but barely. Now they're going to have to play Nebraska. Nebraska's a great team. Nebraska just comes off a loss. And if Nebraska has blood in the water, if they're going to rebound, this is the week to rebound. Ohio State has not played well for 2 weeks straight, and now you're going to get a North or a Nebraska team coming to town. Nebraska goes on the road. Nebraska plays a good game this week. I think Ohio State beats them, and this could be the second loss in a row for Nebraska, but it should be a good game for Ohio State. It should be another test for Ohio State. Ohio State's probably going to go to another great bowl this year. They're not going to go to the four-teamer probably, but they're probably going to go to a great bowl, and they're probably going to win out. I got number six as A&M. A&M, I think, is, again, I like the SEC. So I think after you get through everybody else, I think SEC's got to be where it's at. I think when you start to look at A&M, you start to see a good defense, you see a pretty dynamic offense, and you see them with pretty close losses. Now, they come off of an easy win, New Mexico State or whatever, but then they play Mississippi State. Mississippi State's pretty down this year, but I think they're going to rebound. I think they're going to give A&M a little bit of a good game, and A&M is probably primed to win the rest of their games. Maybe another loss in it. Louisville. Louisville had trouble, man. Louisville beats Virginia, but barely, and they really had to struggle to do it. I think they got the best player in the country, the most electric player, the most fun player to watch, but that doesn't necessarily mean they're the best team, and they're not really in that conference that's going to surprise people. So I really think that Louisville is probably on the outside looking in. They're playing BC this weekend, but I don't know about Louisville right now. I would say that they're on the outside looking in. Wisconsin. Wisconsin is a team that keeps showing up. They beat Nebraska. They barely lose to Michigan, right? They're the team to beat. They're the team to beat. I think if you can beat Wisconsin, you can really show up in that Big Ten. I think Wisconsin, though, is going to trip up again. I don't think they have enough offense to really score big-time points. They're going to play Northwestern this weekend. I think they're going to get that win, but they're probably going to see another loss in their future. Florida State. Florida State, I got at the number 9 because I think Florida State has played games real close. They've lost to great teams this year. And you know what? Keep it close. Florida State, man, I really think that Florida State should be recognized in there. Now, Florida State, Louisville, you could probably kind of look at that game if they could play each other right now. Who would win that game? I kind of like Florida State. See, that's kind of how I'm thinking. I got number 10 at Nebraska. I think Nebraska is still a pretty solid team. They'll probably lose to Ohio State this weekend, probably keep it close, and then drop out of the rankings or drop closer down to 15-ish on there for me. Number 11, I got Florida. I'm trying to sneak in some more SEC if I can find them. I think Florida's got a good ranking right now based on their record right now, but I don't know how their record reflects their actual team right now. They play at Arkansas. That's going to be a hell of a game this weekend. That's going to be an SEC game, so I'll be watching that one for sure on CBS. And then we've got Auburn. Auburn beats Ole Miss. I got Auburn as number 12. Basically, I'm just trying to add more SEC, like I said. I think Auburn, though, is a pretty legit team. They got 2 losses, but then they play a Vandy team. I think they're going to beat Vandy. And I think they just keep padding their schedule until you get to that Iron Bowl. Now, they could make it interesting. I don't think they're going to beat Bama, but I think they're going to make it interesting on them. Then I got my 13th spot as Utah. So I don't have a Pac-12 team in that whole thing except for Washington until you get Utah. Utah doesn't drop too much for me because they lost to Washington on a really good play at the end of the game. And they were really close with them most of the game. But I think Utah is a very solid team. I just don't think they have the offense to hang with any of these other teams above them. I think they get beat by everybody above them, including the team behind them, which is Oklahoma. I think Oklahoma's on a surge right now, and I think Oklahoma, if they had Auburn right now, could win. I think if they had Utah right now, they'd definitely win. But I think Oklahoma's on a little bit of an uptick. They play at Iowa State, though, on Thursday night, and Ames, tough place to play on a Thursday night, so watch out for that one. Baylor slides all the way down to 15. You got to give Baylor some love, but you know what? Baylor loses the game. They probably shouldn't. And you know what? Baylor probably shouldn't have been up there to begin with. So they're going to have that game that they're going to have the 1 loss treated like 2 losses, basically. Last week, you had the game of the week. Obviously, it was Clemson winning. Nebraska losing to Wisconsin. And then you had that huge game where UW beats Utah. Games next week. This is a big week. Obviously, Bama, LSU, I like Bama. You got Nebraska, Ohio State. I like Ohio State, but I like this one close. And Oklahoma, Iowa State. I like Oklahoma, but I like that one shockingly close. And I like that one because it's a Thursday night game. I think a lot of people will watch. I think it gives a lot of people an opportunity to look back at Oklahoma and maybe give Oklahoma the nod as the best team in the Big 12. Right now, it's hard to say that they are because Baylor's got a better record, but I think they are. So if I had to rank them right now, I'd say Oklahoma's the best in the Big 12. Obviously, Bama's the best in the SEC. I would say that Michigan's the best in the pack or in the Big Ten, and then you got Washington the best in the pack. It's a pretty simple thing right now. ACC is the interesting one because you got Clemson right now, you know, and Clemson's had a great year. So why not just add that to the pack? You know, I don't know how the rest of the schedule works for Clemson right now. We'll look at that later on. But I think Clemson's in one of those situations where they are the 4th team in right now. I think Washington slid themselves up into that 2nd or 3rd spot. Hopefully. Probably not 2nd because people love Michigan. The Riders love Michigan. But I would love to see the end schedule go that 1, 2, 3, 4 where those 2 middle games get to go and play the Rose Bowl. It's not going to be at the Rose Bowl, but it would be the Rose Bowl matchup that would be natural with the Big Ten, Pac-10. And then let Clemson and Bama play each other. I think that'd be great. Okay, guys, check out those other videos if you're interested. And we'll see you guys next week. Have a great one, everybody. Adios!